Welcome to this look at new mods on Farming Simulator 19 with me, MrSealyp. It's Wednesday the 12th of August and it's still hot. I seem to spend my life apologising at the moment. Apologies for the start of yesterday's video. I did the whole mod review. It was boiling hot. Turned the fan back on when I finished doing it. Then edited everything together. Did the intro. I forgot to turn the fan off, so I apologise for the fan noise at the start of the video yesterday. It's all off today, so we shouldn't have a problem, in theory. There are some updates for today. The updates are as follows. From left to right, the Pigsty and Chicken Coop by DanielX321, the Grain Garage by DanielX321, and the Storage Shed 5x15m by GeForce Modding have all had updates today. So straight into it. Should be a lot easier today. There aren't as many mods. They dropped fairly early today as well. And the ones that we have got aren't too complicated, which is nice. So, in front of us, we have got the Desk Sleeper. This is by Adub Modding. This is a sleep trigger that you can place wherever you want. Weirdly, if I go up to it and press L3, nothing happens. You actually have to kind of get onto the chair. Then the trigger will come up. Now when you come onto the map, most maps will only allow you to have one sleep trigger, and normally when you start on a new map or on the map, it will put you where your trigger is. When I came back onto the map after saving it, it put me right in the chair, but I couldn't get off the chair. I had to tab to a vehicle. So that's something to bear in mind. If you use this and you come onto the map and think, hang on a minute, just tabbing off of it and you can come away from it. But it is a sleep trigger, he says. There you go, trying to get it to work again. Nicely detailed. It looks like a table and chairs. A table and chair. Can't have many friends around when you use this one. So, you'll find this under placeables. I had a nightmare yesterday with this. This one is under farmhouses. And it's there. It's only 200. And it's only one slot. So, that kind of puts it in the same category as the deck chair and the farmhouse doormats. If you don't want to spend a lot of money and you want to have a trigger somewhere on your map to sleep through the night, that may be the thing for you. So there you go, Desk Sleeper by Adub Modding. Moving on, we've got this here. This is the Selfmade Fence by HajstelMods. Wooden fence panel and a post. That's what you get together with this, but then obviously you can join these together. I don't normally do it, but I had a bit of a fiddle around and put together just four panels and four posts. If you want to keep one cow in there. but anyway, so yeah, I mean, you just, that one's off a little bit. But, you know, you can put fencing around whatever you want. That's the whole point of fencing, isn't it? This you'll find, this one I think was miscellaneous. There we go, the fence post is 40. These are only one slot each as well. 40 for the fence post, 100 for the fence panel, and place them however you want to. That's entirely up to you. Moving on, let's go to these. These have been eagerly anticipated from FS17. This is the BSM truck 850 and 850 IT. Now I think these came out separately on 17, or we got the 850 and then the IT came later, but they're together in a pack. Now this is by BlackSheep Modding and NMC, North Modding Company. So a kind of collaboration on this one. 850 horsepower. We've got the hook lift variant here, which is slightly longer. It will work or should work with pretty much every hook lift container. Again, I haven't been able to test every single one. And obviously filling them all with various different things, you may get slightly different physics and dynamics with it. But yeah. Nice looking mod. Nice details. A few different options on these as well. This is the standard 850. They do have trailer hitches on the back, which is nice. So that's your regular, and there's your hook lift. Trying to think. We'll have a look at them actually. Engine sound and lights and all that in a second. But you'll find these under vehicles, under trucks. So the 850 standard is 195 grand straight off the bat. They're 15 slots. It's 15 slots for the 850, 16 slots for the 850 IT if you're on console. Yeah, I mean, options available. We can change the main colour, which changes the bulk of the colour on the vehicle, like so. We can change the design colour. Hang on, no, that was still the main colour. We can change the design colour, like so, which does the stripes on the vehicle, like that. Those are those options. Then design, we've got standard with bull bar, with spoiler, spoiler and bull bar, and then back to standard again. It comes automatically with the strobe bar across the top. That's on there all the time. I'm quite partial to the strobe bar. I do like those. Then warning signs, we can have standard, oversized load, Lang LKW, and the Convoi Exceptionnel. And then we've got the option 3-point hitch. I know a lot of people will use the front lifter option on various different vehicles if they want to do this, but this pack comes with the front lifter, the 3-point link option already on it. There's various different applications you can use this for when you're doing that. There's no engine configuration. 850 horsepower is what you get. You can't tune it up or down. So the hook lift version, I think the options are pretty much all the same. Main colour again is the main design colour, like so. Now if you decide to go with the 3-point hitch on the front and then put your other things on, like your bull bar, spoiler or without, when you do the sign this time, it puts the sign a little bit higher. I think it was a little bit higher. Was it across the front without? Yeah. So if I have a 3-point link, it puts the oversized load sign a little bit higher up, like so. And then this one has got the IT runner hitch on the back. So what does it sound like? Horn. A little bit muted, but not too bad. Strobe lights on the top. Lights full, like so. If I open up the help menu to my side, there are no options to open or close doors or anything like that, but this will run up to 62 miles an hour. Like I say, trailer hitch in the back makes it quite handy. The front 3-point does have a PTO as well. I think when you hook up at the back, although it's not a PTO on there, the PTO does seem to kind of attach. I know I tried it on one of the trailers a minute ago, but now I have found, actually we're going to do a quick test on this because that's what I was going to look at. The turning circle, I remember on FS17, the turning circles weren't great. A bit like trying to turn a battleship. So let's have a quick look, shall we? Actually, that's not too bad at all. The rear axle isn't steering on the standard version, but I think it is on the hook lift version. That's not too bad a turning circle, actually. Inside, nice, neat and tidy, but I do like, if we turn the lights off, lights on, scroll through our light options, and we've also got one for our strobes, our hazard lights. It's a small thing, you don't get it very often, but I do like it when you do get it. Very nice indeed. So the hook lift one, exactly the same. Same engine, same details, everything's the same inside as far as I can tell. This one I didn't go with the 3-point, I didn't go with the sign or anything like that, just the bull bar. I didn't go with the spoiler on this one either. But when you hook up, again, sometimes when you have hook lifts, they can be a little bit, they catch here and there, and they can be a little bit finicky sometimes. I haven't noticed it as yet with this. That's the larger skip for the the 2633. Looks quite nice like that as a dump loader. But, there you go. That's not sat on straight, is it? Look at that from the back. It's not, is it? Right, let's get up to speed and turn a little bit, see what happens. Hopefully this doesn't come flying off or anything. It doesn't seem to. Unload here. All works, does what it should do. We do have a beacon on the back underneath as well, yeah. Just there. Let's check out the turning circle on this one too. experience that quite right. It's a little bit longer, I think. Yeah, it's definitely a bigger circle on this one, but it is a longer vehicle, and the rear axle does turn on this one. Let's unload it, drop off container. Hopefully we shouldn't have any issues. Yeah, there's a little bit of a wobble there. But again, that could be, you know, there are, like I say, there are so many hook lift attachments and backs and, you know, detach and then fold that away. Nice smooth animation. Nice to see it return to game. I like it. There we go. So, that's the BSM Truck 850 and 850 IT by BlackSheep Modding NMC. Which brings me on to the last of the mods for today. That's right, there's only four. And they have dropped earlier. I'm really concerned that I'm going to get this all ready, edit it, go to post it, and they're going to drop a load more. It has happened before. But we do have this. This is the Valzelli Cubex pack by Mirozed. This is a 40,000 litre slurry tanker. Slurry spreader, sorry, apologies. Really nicely detailed, this as well. Four axle, I suppose 40,000 litres, that's a fair bit of weight in there, isn't it? Yeah, like I say, loads of detail on this. A few different options for spreading as well, which is nice. This is, I believe, on PC compatible with the manure system as well. Yeah, manure system ready. But what is pretty cool with this as well is not only will it do slurry and digestate, this will also take water. So you can, if you've obviously not straight, if you've just slurried, you probably don't want to be putting water in there to feed your animals, but you can use it for feeding animals. It won't spray water, but you can use it as a tanker for taking water to feed your animals if you want to do that. Which I think is quite a nice addition to have on here. There are four different backs. There's the standard spreader. We're going to check these out to see the widths and whatnot. You've got one that spreads to the left and one that spreads to the right. I think that one is the right spreader. And this one here, it's like the fire hose type one. Various different spreads on these, and that's what we're going to be having a look at too, because I was curious to see, one, how they worked, and two, how they spread. So, in the store, you'll find these under tools, under slurry tanks, not manure spreaders, right at the very end. 85 grand for 40,000 litres, that's not too bad at all, actually. Requires 320 horsepower, and it does say 15 metre spread there. It will run at 7 miles per hour, which is a little bit slower. Some of the other ones run at 12s and 9s and things, don't they? Where are we on that one? 10 miles an hour, 12 miles an hour. Yeah, so it's a little bit slower actually at 7. But anyway, we can change the rim colour to anything on that palette, like so. We can change the main colour, which changes the body, like that. And then if we go with design colour, all the bits that are yellow on there at the moment will now change colour. Let's go for something that hopefully stands out. There we go. So all those bits there and the bits within the actual decals themselves change to your design colour. We've got the option of Trelleborg or Michelin. Those are two tyre choices. Within those, there are no other options. You get what you get. Then we've got the option of... it would do that, wouldn't it? On the back, we've got a beacon up the top there. We can have beacon. We can have beacon with extra work lights. We can have a double beacon with extra work lights, and then back to single beacon again. I haven't been able to get those work lights to move or anything. I think they're fixed in place. And then we've got around the front, we've got PTO1 and PTO2, slightly beefed up, chunkier kind of covers on the PTO. And then we've got on the back, so we've got the exact scatter. The exact scatter does 15 meter spread. Then we've got a 90 right, a 90 left. I went with the 90 right. 90 right, 90 left. That does 6.5 meters either way. And then we've got the spear, and the spear goes out to 35 meters. That being said, at 35 meter spread, you're going to get through 40,000 litres pretty quick, but that's not too bad. So those are the things we're going to have a quick look at. If we jump in the tractor now, open up the help menu. What we do also have to the side here, this is for the manure system on PC, but if you want to go for a more kind of realistic feel, if you're doing it on console, L1 and right stick side to side will swing it open that way. Up and down we'll do that. And if we go to my right stick, R1 and then right stick, if we go up and down, gives an extension on that as well, so you can put it into kind of pits or by pits or the slurry things, again just to give you a bit more realism if you want to go down that route on console. Now on this one, R1 and my right stick, there is the option that says up and down, side to side. Side to side doesn't work on any other version other than the one that's got the spear, because that actually controls the spear. Let's go like that, and maybe see if it's on. There we go. Let's bring that in. Like so. Beacons on the back. Lights, etc. So what we're going to do is just hire a worker on this one. So that's the 15 metre. That's the standard spread. Disconnect from that. And I'm sure I went for the 90 right, didn't I? Yep. So options, all the controls are exactly the same on this one. So hire a worker on this one. And that will give you 6.5 metre out to the side. So it depends what sort of application you want to go for. If you go for the 90 left, it will obviously put it on the other side. And then we've got the spear. Now, I'm not sure, I'm hoping the spear works with the worker, because I think trying to drive this and control the spear at the same time is going to prove quite difficult. Ah, that's interesting. I've got no option there to hire a worker. Ah. Now that's a bit of a nightmare, for a couple of reasons. Well, one, it's going to be quite fiddly to do. Anyway, plus you can't then leave a worker to get on with it at 35 metres, which would be quite nice, especially with a console controller, because to operate that spear, I need to have R1, and then my right stick needs to be going side to side. Can you see the spear moving now? Oh, not the beacons. Let's zoom in a bit. See the spear moving? So R1 and right stick moves the spear side to side. So I suppose what you're going to have to do is set it off on cruise control, turn it on. I'm just worried you're going to lose a lot. Let's turn it on, and then you have to control the spread of that. But blimey, that is mad. Look at the spread on that. Why is that not turning back? That. That is crazy. Look at the spread. That is absolutely mad. But I suppose at 7 miles an hour, it does give you a bit more control. If I turn it off again. Wow. The problem is, if you do make a slight mistake, you are going to miss bits. And the faster you go, the less it spreads. You notice here, you've got quite a thick spread this side. And that side, we've got a few gaps. But that is bonkers. Now, I'm not bothered about whether it spreads in the field now or not. Let's just put that on again. Let's have a look. Yeah, see, that's the problem. Because it's R1 and right stick side to side, but up and down is what moves that. So, if you're familiar with the PlayStation controller, it's probably going to be the same on Xbox as well. Trying to go side to side, and at any point without going up or down, in this case up, we'll do that. So I need to keep my right stick pulled down and go left to right, because if I push up at any point, that bar there is going to go down into the ground and cause me problems. So that's why it's going to be a little bit fiddly to do this on console. But let's get on again. Let's turn it on. Zoom out. That is absolutely Because I'm thinking, oh, it's going to be 35 metres. It's 35 metres all the way out. So potentially you're doing 70 metres if you swing side to side. 70 metres slurry spreading. And I'll be honest with you, that's not actually going down as fast as I thought it was going to. If you look to the right, I know I'm not actually putting on a field. I thought that would be going down way further. Interesting that you can't hire a worker, though. That's an interesting one. But anyway, that's the Valzelli Cubex pack by Mirozed. That's quite cool. I might have a bit of a play around with that. I've got a load of digestate that I've just made on Stone Valley. So maybe to use that up using one of these might be quite a handy bit of kit to have. Anyway, that's it. That's the mods for today. I hope you found it useful and informative in some way, shape or form. If you have, give us a like. If you don't subscribe yet, please do. If you want to leave a comment, feel free. And if you want to share this video, then please be my guest. Whatever you should choose to do. Thanks for watching.